How's it going, everyone? And welcome to the show.
I'm your host, Mike Starr.
Hola, mi nombre es Miguel. ¿Cómo estás, señor, señorita? And on today's video, I've got a really cool Spanish-speaking movie that was made in Mexico by none other than director Alejandro González Iñárritu. The director who made such films, or I should say directed such films as 21 Grams, Babel, Birdman, very famous film, starring Michael Keaton, and The Revenant. Written by Guillermo Arrieta. And that movie is Amoros Perros, roughly translated as Loves Dogs or Dogs or Dog Loves, if I understand correctly. This is released by Umbrella Entertainment. Really, really nice release. Comes with a slipcase and everything. We'll get into the unboxing. But I want to tell you a little bit about this movie because this is the first time it's ever been released here in Australia on Blu-ray. Now, my brother rented this when I was a bit younger from our local video store when I was a kid. Civic Video back in the days. But yeah, this is a very long movie. I got through half of it last night. It goes for around 153 minutes. Very, very long film, but it's actually quite a well-made film. It's very similar to the style of that of Pulp Fiction. It's about all these little stories intertwined into one story, and it has multiple characters similar to that of Pulp Fiction. It did come out in the year 2000, so Pulp Fiction was made prior to this, so maybe they got inspired by it. But anyways, with a budget of 2.4 million. This film was a success at the box office. It grossed 20.9 million. Hang on. Oh, that's why. Okay. Yeah, it does star actors that I've never heard of because I haven't seen too many Mexican movies in my life. It stars Emilio Endurvia, Gayo Garcia Bernal and Goyo Toledo. But the film, in a nutshell, I'll tell you in a bit, but I'll give you my rating on the specs and the movie as a whole. So my rating for audios and visuals, I haven't seen the DVD, like even though it was back in the days my brother watched it, never saw it, but it's actually quite good quality. So overall, I'll give it a 9 out of 10 because I couldn't really fault the audio / visuals. An overall rating for the movie, give it an 8 out of 10. Solid 8 out of 10. Like, compared to Pulp Fiction, it's not really as good as Pulp Fiction, but as a movie, actually, yeah, I'll give it an 8 out of 10. It was good, but I did expect a lot more from it. Maybe it's a bit of a slow burn film, but maybe after, I don't know, the first hour and a half, because I only saw like an hour and a half of it, it picks up. But yeah, I definitely didn't like the aspect of the dogfighting in the movie because I'm very much against animal cruelty, even though it's not real. I just don't like to see that stuff because it's really upsetting. But maybe that's common in Mexico. I don't know because I don't know much about the Mexican culture or what they do in the underworld there. But anyways, so yeah, audios, visuals, and packaging. So audios and visuals, 9 out of 10. The movie as a whole, 8 out of 10. And the packaging, 9 out of 10. So put that there. Okay, synopsis time. The film opens up with the best way I can describe this, it opens up with the character, this young guy who's got a Rottweiler. It shows his life, but it shows the dog fighting, and then it shows how the dog fighting comes into his life. Because one day the best fighting dog fights his dog on the street by accident. Well, not by accident, just by a chance, and then ends up fighting and winning all the fights. And then, yeah, pretty much it opens up with the guy. The first scene is them escaping from this ute, and they're in a car, and this pickup truck in America, you call it. and they get into a car crash, then it goes back and shows the dog fighting. So that's pretty much how it opens. And then it goes to this homeless man's story who takes care of dogs, and then it goes to this actress chick who gets it. She was in that car accident at the start of the movie, so it's non-linear, and then it shows, yeah, it just shows her life and how she's in a wheelchair, and then I think that's where I stopped watching it. But yeah, it's quite a long movie. 8 out of 10, because I don't know, it's different for me. It's just not my style. Like, it's a well-made movie, don't get me wrong. I love Alessandro's work. Like, The Revenant's one of my favorite films, and I haven't seen Birdman or 21 Grams or Bay Bell, but yeah, it's getting quite hot here. So let's get to the unboxing, and then we'll do the outro. Let's go. Boom. And here we have some mail for good old Mike Starr. Let's see what this baby is. Oh my gosh. Oh shit. Ameros Peros on Blu-ray. I actually got a good deal on this. This was around $14-$15 Aussie dollars. Or maybe it was a bit more. But anyways, they had a $10 discount if you sign up with JB Hi-Fi on the internet and make an account. So I only got this for like $6-$7. But yeah, this is a Mexican film. My brother has seen it, but I have not seen this one. And yeah, it looks really good, to be honest. It's a bit like the Mexican version of Pulp Fiction. It's about these stories that... different stories that come together, similar to that of good old Orange Pulp Fiction. But okay, let me just put that there. So yeah, this is what the front looks like. Ameros Peros by Umbrella Entertainment, coming on Umbrella Entertainment. I message you every day so I can get review copies and so I can work with you, because I love you guys. Yeah, so let's take that out. Boom. The inside looks like not have. Okay, there we go. Some kind of Japanese writing, even though it's a Mexican film. It's unusual. Okay, it's not broken. It's the disc. Put that there. It's got like a whole bunch of writing here about the production. So I'll put this back. And yeah, that's, I guess, Ameros Peros in a nutshell on Blu-ray. So that's it for this video, everyone. What can I say? Ameros Peros, an unusual Spanish-speaking Mexican film by Umbrella Entertainment. This is part of their World Cinema line. They've got a couple of different lines. Umbrella, like behind me, they've got like their what's this one called? This is another Umbrella. Central Cinema releases. Umbrella's a pretty good company, and I've messaged you guys a couple times, so Umbrella, don't ignore me. I'm one of your biggest supporters. But anyways, without further ado, I'm just gonna end this video here by saying thank you all for watching. And yeah, if you've liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if you have any questions or if any chicks want to DM me. Yeah. But yeah, if you haven't subscribed, what the f*** are you doing? Subscribe to this f***ing channel now before I, go out there, kick your door down, and let's just leave it at that. But if you have subscribed, thank you all for supporting this channel. I really mean it. You know, without any of you people out there from around the world, Mike Starr would just be flicking his foreskin. But yeah, without further ado, I just want to say thank you all for watching again. And I'll catch you all in my next video. And by the way, I've got a really big surprise for my next video. So you want to fucking subscribe, otherwise you're going to miss out when it comes to getting notified for that video, so don't miss out. Mike Starr signing off, saying have a good night, and I'll catch you all then. See ya!